Breaking news out of Washington. President Trump is defending his son Don Jr. this morning after the release of those explosive emails. There has been a lot of smoke about the Trump team's willingness to work with the Russians to defeat Hillary Clinton. These emails, the first flames. They are now the subject of intense interest from four separate investigations, including special counsel Robert Mueller. The revelations have rocked an already chaotic White House. ABC's chief White House correspondent Jonathan Karl is there. Good morning, John.
Good morning, George. Donald Trump Jr. has firmly denied doing anything wrong, but he is now acknowledging that it may not have been a good idea to meet with that Russian lawyer.
In retrospect, I probably would have done things a little differently.
In his first interview since the story broke, Donald Trump Jr. says it was a snap decision in the heat of the campaign to accept that invitation from someone he was told worked for the Russian government and had dirt on Hillary Clinton.
Things are going a million miles an hour. You know what it's like to be on a campaign. We just won Indiana, but we're talking about a contested convention. Things are going a million miles an hour again. And hey, wait a minute. I've heard about all these things, but maybe this is something. I should hear him out.
In a startling development Tuesday, Don Jr. released the emails that show he was told the Russian government wanted to help his father's campaign and that he was willing, even eager, to accept the Russian help.
The emails detail how a Trump acquaintance and publicist involved in the Miss Universe pageant in Moscow said the Russian lawyer had, quote, official documents and information that would incriminate Hillary and her dealings with Russia and would be very useful to your father, adding, this is obviously very high-level and sensitive information, but it's part of Russia and its government's support for Mr. Trump. Don Jr. responds, if it's what you say, I love it. 6 days later, the meeting at Trump Tower was on. Don Jr., Trump's son-in-law Jared Kushner, now a top advisor at the White House, and then campaign manager Paul Manafort, all sat down with the lawyer, Natalia Veselnitskaya.
It was literally just a wasted 20 minutes, which was a shame.
There's no evidence the lawyer actually provided any information on Clinton, and in fact, she denies she did. But the meeting appears to contradict denials from Trump advisors that the president himself or anybody on his campaign had any contacts whatsoever with Russian officials.
Are there any ties between Mr. Trump, you or your campaign, and Putin and his regime?
No, there are not. It's absurd, and, you know, there's no base to it.
Did anyone involved in the Trump campaign have any contact with Russians?
Absolutely not, and I discussed that with the president-elect just last night.
I have nothing to do with Russia. To the best of my knowledge, no person that I deal with does.
On Capitol Hill, the emails have reignited talk of alleged Russian collusion.
These are his words, not mine, his. This was an attempt at collusion.
Hillary Clinton's former running mate raised the stakes even higher.
This is moving into perjury, false statements, and even into potentially treason.
We haven't even caught a glimpse of the president here at the White House since this story broke over the weekend. And George, today is the third straight day without a single public event on the president's schedule. Now, there is a tweet, though, just a few moments ago from the president about this. He says, my son Donald did a good job last night. He was open, transparent, and innocent. This is the greatest witch hunt in political history. Sad.